Number three, the characters. Say what you will, but I do find the characters in the prequels to be memorable and effective. Well, most of them. But I'll get into that issue later. The way I see it, the characters from the prequels are becoming just as iconic as the characters from the original. Just naming a few, you got Padme, Darth Maul, Count Dooku, Mace Windu, General Grievous, and a whole bunch of minor characters who stood out with even the short screen time that they had.
Well, there is one character who overshadows the rest. A character without rival. Truly the epitome of greatness. And that character is Qui-Gon Jinn.
They're so great, he didn't even need to be on the council. The man who put the importance in Obi-Wan Kenobi. Oh, he could say things that he was only in one movie, but he only needed one. He could also say he was wrong about Anakin being the chosen one.
But was he really? Was he?
And to top everything off, the man was killed and then found a way to come back as a spirit. I guess what I'm getting at is that even with all the issues, the characters were just as effective and left an impression.
Oh, and you don't mess with Qui-Gon.
Number two, Jar Jar Binks. You knew it was coming, but it does come a bit of a shock that he's in my number two. Anyways, let's just get right into it. Jar Jar Binks is the epitome of stupidity. The definition of the Star Wars fans' hatred for the prequels. I don't even think I need to joke about how stupid this character is. Most pop culture really does it for me. Hell, even creators have joked about how stupid the character is. Despite all the hatred for the character, for me personally, it's died down over the years. Actually, it's come to the point where I don't mind him.
Shut up.
I think what helps is the Clone Wars. Even though he's still annoying on the series, he seems a little more subtle, and I can tolerate that. Oh, and one more thing before I close this section. The whole situation with Jar Jar being the reason that Palpatine got power, well, for those of you who don't know, I'll just get the details about it. Because of Padme's absence in Episode 2, Jar Jar decided to bring it upon himself to give the Chancellor supreme executive power. Most fans have seen this as just another thing to rack to Jar Jar's mistakes in life. However, I see the situation in a different perspective. Yes, this was not a smart move on Jar Jar's part, but what choice did he have? My guess is that he was only thinking that this was something Padme would have done. It might have not been a smart move, but he was trying to do the right thing. Plus, Palpatine was the one who gave him the idea, so he was getting the power anyway. So why are we blaming Jar Jar? I guess this is another excuse to hate him for being such an annoying character.
He's no representative, he's a plague!
Number two, the lightsaber combat. Lightsabers are always fun, and seeing them in action from the originals is always great. But what I saw in the prequels, honestly, I couldn't believe it. The idea of lightsaber combat has come a long way to the point where each character's style is unique from each other. On top of that, the duels in the prequels are outstanding, each of them standing out on their own. One duel in particular is the very reason why I could tolerate Episode 1. See, that 1 minute of action makes it all worth it sitting through the 133 minutes that is The Phantom Menace, which just goes to show how redefining the lightsaber duels have been in the Star Wars prequels. Number one reason to dislike the Star Wars prequels is...
You're an angel.
What?
An angel. I heard the deep roar. I'll show you my racer. I'm building a pod racer. It wasn't my fault, really. Saboba Flashmouth is Vin.
It's working! It's working!
Oh, I know.
Young Anakin Skywalker. My God, just... My God. When the films first came out, he didn't bug me as much. Then again, I didn't know any better. But now that I'm older and wiser, I can now see that young Anakin is like nails on a frickin' chalkboard. He's supposed to be a slave, so it would make sense that his character would be a little colder than most kids. But he's not portrayed that way. And to make it worse, is that it doesn't make any sense for his further character development in the other films. He's just so bland in the first film, and it's just weak. Thank God for Qui-Gon Jinn.
Get used to that.
I can tolerate Anakin in any other film, despite being whiny, but the one time I cannot stand him is young Anakin Skywalker.
Now this is pod racing.
And my number one reason to like the Star Wars prequels is Obi-Wan versus Anakin. I guess I could have considered this to be in the number two spot, but I realize this deserves a spot on its own. It was the moment that was inevitable as soon as the prequels appeared. You knew that no matter how things would go down, Anakin was going to fight Obi-Wan. And personally, it was well worth the wait. When I see this scene, I see a whole bunch of things. For one, it could be a very simple melodramatic scene with good versus evil. On the other hand, it's an escalation that was being built up in Episode 3 and keeps the atmosphere to the film very much alive. Not only that, but the scene itself is very tragic. Obi-Wan and Anakin were practically brothers, so to see Obi-Wan duel Anakin is very sad, and actually gives him a little more depth than the original trilogy. I will admit that if you want to see more depth in the scene, you should probably see a little more in the expanded universe, like Clone Wars, to understand where I'm coming from. But I think the movies do well enough with the situation. This epic duel is tragic, emotional, and it's well worth the wait, which makes it my number one pick for the reason to watch the prequels.
And those are my reasons to both like and hate the Star Wars prequels. Take it as you will, but in the end, I still find them to be very entertaining.
Look, I do understand the frustration and disappointment about these films, but for every bad thing, there is a good thing as well. However, I can also understand that there is a lot you have to deal with to get to the good points. So I'm not expecting to change any opinion. Next time you see the prequels, just get some thoughts.
And that about does it. Finally! I've been waiting to say that for years. I only can bury the hatchet. Feels good, actually. I'm Timdiana, and I've just... Hold on.